Well, I wanted to show how this Green Works electric lawnmower works. This is the 80 volt Ultimate Max Green Works electric lawnmower. The battery takes about an hour to charge, and at first when you get it, it lasts about an hour, but it dwindles down to about 40 minutes after that. I've had it for over a year, just about a year, and that's what it's doing now. The thing is just beat up and everything, unmaintained, and it just keeps going. It's dirty, dirt collects in the battery compartment, everything. It just keeps going. I busted the top lid off. It's very fragile on the flaps, but it still snaps on. So it's still going. It has seven elevation handles. And right now I'm in 1, 2, 3 up from the ground, from its lowest setting, which is what I'm chopping all this tall grass. I could go higher. It also knows if the grass is too tall or low and alters the speed of the blade. It's like intelligent, and then if it catches resistance, it speeds up. So let's give it a whirl. Press this button and pull back. So it cut out on me after 10 minutes. I don't know if there's a timer on this camera or not for video, but I got all of it mowed down, had a couple of mole hills that I had to go through that made a lot of dust, ran into a spider at the end. Oh yeah, man. But this lawnmower so far since I've been here, just, you know, in 3 days of mowing, I've mowed around the shed, around the house, around the barn, the entire front yard, and all up here. Now, it's taken 3 days because of the charge of this thing. It's a 21-inch deck, and it's the 80-volt Ultramax Greenworks. That's what I'm using. The battery is right in here. I broke this cover off, pushed down that, and took the battery out, and that's the battery it charges. It takes about an hour. So if you want to go uninterrupted, I would get 3 of these, and you'd probably be good. Look how dusty and dirty it is. But it goes. And to start it, literally, you push this button right here and pull back on that. Let go and it stops. Now over here, it's got all these adjustment settings. That's the lowest sight right there. All the way up here is the highest. So if I was to bring it all the way to the back, it really gets some serious clearing. Right now I have it on mulch mode. There is a bag for it. And there is a side vent for it as well. I don't use it, I just let it mulch. The side thing falls off a lot. The bag fills up really quick, so I just don't use it. So, there you have it. Cutting trees, trimming trees, as you can see over here. All the branches are down. Some of them were hitting the trailer when I was pulling back and forth, the white trailer there. So some of these trees that are leaning over and crooked, I'm gonna cut down. I gotta make room for the garden and all the crops that we're gonna be growing. A lot of the trees in the middle are gonna stay. And just, you know, it's winter time. I don't have much of a winter crop started, but I gotta do what I can right now, and that's get ready for some animals to get in here, goats and chickens. And I had to talk to John Deere. I got approved for a loan, but I don't, you know, for a tractor, backhoe, loader and everything, but the down payment is too expensive. They want 10% down, $2,700. I can't do that. So I need that money to buy fencing and animals. So I'm gonna see if that same financing is good for just a rider lawnmower, which is about $3,000, and then put 10% down on that, it's only $300. So see if they'll do that. They're supposed to call me back this week and we'll find out. I'll let you know. All right, so the first week on the homestead is work and getting it ready. Don't just grab animals and get them in here. I've mowed this area because this is just going to be crops. I don't want animals here. I don't have enough fence to fence this in, and it's cheaper if I just keep charging this battery. We'll see when I get my electric bill, to get this area ready so I can start putting cardboard down and a tarp over it and tarp this for the winter and let everything just mulch into the ground. Then February, I'll peel it all back, see if we've created a good worm bed. And if not, put some fertilizer down, sprinkle it everywhere, and start growing. We're gonna be doing corn right where I'm standing. And then down here is gonna be Veronica's garden. And then past there will be the melons and the squash that I've talked about. There's just so much to do, and I'm only one person. So I don't know. If any other homesteaders are traveling through Texas and you come through South Central Texas, east of San Antonio, between Houston and San Antonio, along the I-10 corridor, and you want to stop and lend a hand, hey, hit me up. I could use the help. I got a 3-bedroom, so you can stay inside the trailer, and it's a manufactured home. Yeah. I mean, there's no internet here, but cell phone service works and data works. It's what I use to upload all my videos is my cell phone. So that is my internet. And you just heard my phone go off with a message from Facebook. So I'll talk to y'all later. And thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, ring the bell, do it a little dance. Get down tonight. Get down tonight. No, you don't like my dancing? Fine. Bye.